Prime Minister Anthony Albanese is taking off for the NATO summit in Europe tomorrow, leaving some angry MPs and senators in his wake. While the new parliament isn't due to sit for a month, the fireworks have already started.
The Prime Minister marking a milestone.
It's been 1 month since Australia voted for change.
But one change he's making has put the cross in the crossbench.
It's very incredibly short-sighted of the Prime Minister.
This move from the PM is damaging and hugely disrespectful.
Anthony Albanese is slashing staff numbers for independent MPs and senators.
We get a letter asking us to sack 3 out of 4 of our advisers.
We're all making cuts, we're all making savings. The budget's in pretty average shape.
Leaving teal independents seeing red.
It's basically saying, well, I don't respect the work the crossbench has done in the last parliament or can do in this coming parliament.
While senators, including former Wallabies captain David Pocock, Pauline Hanson, and Jackie Lambie, say it's a direct attack on the Australians who voted for them. This act, at the beginning of this new parliament and new government, has significantly damaged relationships with the crossbench. We urge the Prime Minister to reconsider his decision. And if he doesn't, he may struggle to get bills through the Senate, where the Greens and Independents hold the balance of power.
If I'm unclear about something or not able to get totally across it and know how to vote on behalf of the ACT, then it'll be very hard to vote.
Well, we're hoping that, everyone will be sensible about this.
Tomorrow, Anthony Albanese will head to Europe to attend the NATO summit and meet the French president in a bid to heal the relationship between France and Australia, which was rocked by a broken submarine deal. And now it seems when the Prime Minister returns home, the government will have more fences to mend.
Well, it's certainly not off to a good start with the crossbench.
Fiona Willen, Nine News.